Well, in a world where we aspire for perfection, Kilkenny are the ones who've reached the peak more often than any others in recent years. Are the chasing pack, cat hunting as opposed to stag hunting, getting any closer? It's got to be Michael Wadding from Waterford who'll be in charge this afternoon. Kilkenny won the toss. They'll play from right to left in the first half. It's exactly the same as their Miners who beat Dublin. From memory, I think it was 120 to 10 points. So Kilkenny from right to left, the defending Leinster champions. Switches and changes been made already. And Aidan Hart gone to the corner. Damien Hayes got in towards full forward. As the referee gets the match underway. And Galway look for an early start here now with Angus Callanan trying to launch the opening attack. Balanced here towards Aidan Hart, and Hart puts that one between the post and over the bar. Very good start in the opening attack. 15 seconds goal on the clock.
That was a very important score, Ger, because it was a narrow enough angle, and sometimes you see players taking shots from there, hitting them wide, but that was a very good start for Galway and a great start for himself.
Well, Aidan Hart from Gort back in the championship team once again. So now the pressure being exerted on the Galway backs. Damien Joyce going back there off his left-hand side. Coming out here to meet it, Jackie Terrell. Big, strong man from James Stevens, linking up with Michael Fennelly. Last year's captain came on in the final. That's just going narrowly to the left. Looked like it was going to start off on target, but then the breeze didn't do him any favours. Stepping inside here, looking for Kilkenny's opening score, just failing to make it. Big Ballyhale Shamrocks man, 25 years of age now, linking up with Michael Rice in the middle of the field. That puck out, once again it's Jackie Turrell who's back sweeping, takes it away, past defenders, almost unchallenged, towards Eddie Brennan. Trying to swing at it there, and the line ball in the end is going to be a Kilkenny one. Tiny bit of a dispute about it. John McIntyre, the Galway manager, has done a very, very good job. National League champions, of course, but coming in here now against the All-Ireland and Leinster champions. Fennelly to hit this. Kilkenny looking for their first score. Well defended again. Donal Barry this time, diagonally across over there towards Ir Litanian, trying to take it in his stride, but in comes Tommy Welch, upended. The referee doesn't blow his whistle immediately, and it hots up as a result. And tempers get frayed. And eventually calm is restored. Crowd gets excited. This is how it happened here, Tommy Welch. Well, it was Ir Litanian who was coming in challenging, and eventually the referee did blow the whistle.
Well, he did foul, Ger, there's no question of that, and Tommy Walsh retaliated, possibly a throw-in, probably would have been the right result after that.
No yellow card issued, by the way, but he has been warned, Ir Litanian. There was a serious doubt with a quad injury all through the week. PJ Ryan now to take this from his own 45-metre line. The breeze more or less behind him, dropping it in dangerously there. Henry Shefflin comes out here, tries to make an angle, but he's put this one wide. So two wides by the two men with the first two attacks of this first half for Kilkenny. This latest one by Henry Shefflin. And it's still a point to no score.
That just shows the strength of the wind there, Ger.
Yeah, it is very, very difficult to gauge. Ollie Canning now playing it up there towards Andy Smith. Good control play by Galway, low into the breeze. Ger Farraher back towards Smith again. Now, has he got this one on target? Not quite. It's going to take a while for the players to come to terms with the wind in Croke Park, which is always very, very difficult to try and get a handle on, because it swirls around in certain areas and blows more or less directly in other places. From the puck out, broken down again here to Ger Farraher, having a marvellous season. Big one up there. Damien Hayes is in at full forward, runs all the way back to PJ Ryan, the Fenians man. To the middle of the park. Eddie Brennan has started on the 40. Indeed, Kilkenny have lined up as they were selected. And Michael Fennelly gets his third possession. Little hand pass here, not quite able to link up there with Owen Larkin. Has the shot himself, should be the goalkeeper's. Colm Callanan. Swiftly out as far as Angus Callanan. his namesake from Liam Mellows in the City, City of Galway. And this time the foul is by Joe Canning. Chopping down, the referee has decided. Free to Kilkenny.
Yeah, I think he was a little late with the flick more than a chop then. And Angus Canning should have given the ball to Farragher, who was in a much better position. And then they could have released Joe Canning. So Galway, I think, have a plan of a short hurling. Try and pull the wing backs out. And, you know, they're doing that well, but then they need to stick the ball over the bar when they get a chance. So they seem to have a plan about them. No long balls in and try and drag the Kilkenny half back line out into midfield.
Well, that's going to be interesting to see if they can manage that much, because that half back line has been seemingly impregnable. As Shefflin hits this one, dangerously in, and the goalkeeper again, Colm Caldonan, handles with care, gets it out, Tony O'Gregan, big one way down the field, broken up here by JJ Delaney, pressure back on again, comes in here as far as the captain, TJ Reid, trying to step away from trouble there. Over there, the man marking him is David Collins, in is Adrian Cullinan, who's come back from a bad knee injury. Here's TJ Reid, back once again towards Shefflin, neatly inside towards Richie Power, trying to make some room for himself. It's in there towards Larkin, prodding it forward. Oh, that was very, very close. Martin Comerford was arriving, but the angle was too tight for him, and Kilkenny were out of luck.
They were, Gerard, and if he went back far, that was an excellent ball through. And Kilkenny are very good at this. They have a player who comes free, and Martin Comerford maybe could have died for that one. But initially, Gerard, Galway had that ball in the half, their own half back line, and they were a little bit sloppy. They should have cleared it much earlier, and they gave Kilkenny the chance to come back, but that's what they'll do when they get chances.
Colm Callanan's puck out. Again, Tommy Welch there, put under some pressure. And down goes Andy Smith. Referee goes across to have a look. That'll be a very tasty duel between the two of those men, Andy Smith and Tommy Welch. Tommy's no small man by any manner of means. He's 5'10", 5'11". And the referee has given him a yellow card.
Well, he had no option there. No option there, Ger, because Tommy was a little bit wild. He can do that thing at times, and you know, a little rash, and yellow card against him. He'll have to be careful.
Free to Galway to be taken by Ger Farragher. Into the wind, dropping it in, but dropping it to the left. He's missed it. So three wides now by Galway at this stage, by Kilkenny, three wides, two by Galway, just to get it absolutely right. So PJ Ryan has gone back to college in Carlow IT, taking this puck out. Caught very well in there by TJ Reid from his own puck out, delivering it, but not delivering it with accuracy. Players not quite getting their shots on target. That breeze is very, very obviously going to be a major factor here, a major player.
That's right, Ger. And down there at the Hill 16 end, of course, there's no stand, so the wind is inclined to be a bit blustery and it swirls around, so difficult to get your shots on target down there.
That's a poor puck out. It's gone straight to Owen Larkin, returning it, under-hitting it. Goalkeeper has it comfortably, Colm Callanan. Out as far as Ollie Canning. Felt the pressure, in particular here a fortnight ago against Offaly. Just too long with his clearance to Andy Smith. Runs to Tommy Welch instead. Back down towards Martin Comerford, trying to break it. Breaks it to the waiting Eddie Brennan, and Brennan was upended, free in. So it should be a chance for Kilkenny now to get their first score of this match with just over 8 minutes gone. Henry Shefflin ready to line it up. His 11th Leinster final appearance. Well, he scored 4 goals and 79 points up to this in those final appearances. Make it 80 points now, because he's got a first of the day here and the teams are level. So Henry Shefflin levelling up the point by Aidan Hart much earlier on. Manager in pensive mood. Always enthusiastic about Leinster finals, one of the big days in the GAA calendar. This